In this lecture on cardiac embryology, we'll discuss a simplified version of the development of the heart in the series Cardiology for Medical Students. Cardiovascular system is the first system to develop in the embryo. Cardiac progenitor cells develop into cardiac myoblasts. These surround the cardiogenic field formed by the coalescence of blood islands in the mesoderm. The primitive heart tube is formed from the cardiogenic field. The cranial part of the primitive heart tube connects to the dorsal aorta, while the caudal end connects to the venous system. The primitive heart tube has three layers: inner layer of endothelium, which forms the endocardium, the middle layer of myocardium, and outer layer of visceral pericardium. The heart tube elongates and forms the cardiac loop at 23 days of life. The cranial end bends ventrally, caudally, and to the right. Caudal end bends dorsally, cranially, and towards the left. The cardiac loop is fully formed by 28 days of fetal life. Bulbous caudus is formed from the proximal part of the heart tube. Cornus caudus is the middle segment, while the distal part is the truncus arteriosus. The septa form from tissue masses known as endocardial cushions. Parts of the atrial and ventricular septum, atrioventricular walls, and aortopulmonary septum are formed from the endocardial cushions. Septum primum develops from the roof of the common atrium by the end of the fourth week of life. Initially, growth of septum primum stops short of the endocardial cushions, leaving the ostium primum, as shown in this diagram. Later, when the septum primum fuses with the endocardial cushions, ostium primum closes. By this time, perforations develop in the central part of the septum primum, which coalesce to form the ostium secundum. A new septum called septum secundum develops from the upper part of the right atrium, which closes the ostium secundum partially. The lower part of the septum secundum is crescentic, and remaining part of the ostium secundum is the foramen ovale. The septum primum gradually disappears, leaving the lower portion as the valve of the foramen ovale. Foramen ovale allows right to left shunt across the intra-atrial septum in fetal life. After birth, when lungs start functioning, pulmonary venous return increases the left atrial pressure, leading to closure of the valvular foramen ovale. But propatency of foramen ovale may remain in up to 20% of the adults. Of the four endocardial cushions, that is the superior, inferior, and two lateral, the superior and inferior fuse to divide the atrioventricular canal into two. The atrioventricular walls are formed by thinning of the endocardial cushions. Truncal swellings within the truncus rotate and fuse to form the aortico-pulmonary septum. It is the rotation which causes the spiral nature of the septum and special relationship of aorta and pulmonary artery. Division of the cornus caudis also proceeds on similar lines, leading to the formation of right and left ventricular outflow tracts. After completion of the septation, semilunar walls develop by thinning of the tubercles on the truncal swellings. Muscular ventricular septum develops from the muscular ventricular wall. Membranous septum develops from the endocardial cushions. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Thank you.